Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Shivkumar, head of the department, Civil Engineering. Here today I will discuss in my lecture about lime mortars. So let's start with the lime and mortar. The term mortar is used to indicate a paste prepared by adding required quantities of water to a mixture of binding material like cement or lime and with fine aggregates like sand. So mortar is just a mixture or a paste which is made by mixing of cement, sand or lime, sand, adding with the water. The above two components of mortar, namely the binding materials and fine aggregates, are sometimes referred to as the matrix and adulterantly respectively. The mixture of the matrix binds the particles of the adulterants, and such as the durability, quality and strength of mortar will mainly depend on the quality and quantity of the matrix. Yeah, definitely. When we prepare a mortar or lime mortar in a huge quantity, then it is not easy to maintain the quality of the matrix. So it may be variable because the human error, due to human error, the mixture, your proportion which we have taken in the previous may be varied in little quantity. That's why the quality cannot be compared with the previous one. It is uncomparable. The combined effect of the two components of mortar is that the mass is able to bind the bricks or stone firmly. Basically, the mortars are classified in the following four categories based on their bulk density, kind of binding material, nature of applications, and some special kind of mortars I will discuss in this topic. These more special mortars are being prepared for the special kind of purpose. So let's start with the bulk density. According to the bulk density of mortar in dry state, there are two types of mortar. First one is the heavy mortar and second one is the lightweight mortars. So heavy mortars are those mortars which are having bulk density near or more than 15 kilonewton per cubic meter or more, are known as the heavy mortars. They are prepared for heavy quartz or sand material. The next one is the lightweight mortars. The mortars which are having less than 15 kilonewton per cubic meter bulk density are known as lightweight mortars. They are prepared from light porous sands and pumice and other fine aggregates of lightweight. Then second one is the kind of binding material. The kind of binding material for the mortar is selected by keeping in mind the several expected working condition like hardening, temperature, moisture condition and other environmental conditions also. So according to that kind of binding materials, the mortars are classified into five following categories. The first one is the lime mortar, Surkhi mortar, cement mortars, gauze mortar, and gypsum mortar. So, lime mortar. In this type of mortar, the lime is used as a binding material. In this mortar, we usually take either a wet lime or hydraulic lime. There are two types of lime is available in the market. The wet lime shrink greatly extent. So it is required to mix 2 to 3 times its volume of the sand. The lime should be slaked before use. This mortar is unsuitable for the waterlogged areas or damp situation. We should not use this type of lime mortar in making of foundation or well. For the hydraulic lime, the portion of lime to sand by volume is 1:2 or so. This mortar should be consumed within 1 hour after mixing because it hardens, it hardens rapidly. So it is suggested that it should be consumed or it has to be consumed within 1 hour of the mixing. It possesses more strength and can be used in the damp situation. The lime mortar has a high plasticity. It can be placed easily. It possesses good cohesive property with other materials. It shrinks in very little quantity. That's why it is sufficiently durable, but it hardens slowly. It's generally used for the lightly loaded ground parts of the building. Next one is the Surkhi mortar. Normally, Surkhi is the material which is obtained by the grinding of brick. This type of mortar is prepared by using fully Surkhi instead of sand. So, in this kind of mortar, in generally, what we do in the mortars, we just add cement and sand with water and make a paste. This is known as mortar. But in case of Surkhi mortar, we use the Surkhi as a primary material, as a replacement of sand with the cement. The powder of Surkhi should be fine enough to pass BS9C and the residue should not be more than 10% by weight. The Surkhi mortar is used for ordinary masonry for all kinds of foundation and superstructure, but it cannot be used for the plastering and pointing, etc. because it's likely to disintegrate after some time. So the beauty of the wall or the structure may be deteriorated if we apply on the external surface of the wall or any structure. Next one is the cement mortar. In this type of mortar, the cement is used as a binding material. Depending upon the strength, requirement and importance of work, the proportion of the cement and sand may be varied from 1:2 to 1:6. For an example, for the structural part, 1:2 is taken into consideration, and while in the plastering, we can take the 1:6. It should be noted that Surkhi and cinder are not chemically inert substances, hence they cannot be used as an adulterant with matrix as a cement. Thus, the sand only can be used to form the cement mortar. This can be used for the water resisting structures. High strength mortar can be produced by adding this cement and sand. Water saturated soil, here we can place or use this cement mortar. The next is the Gauss mortar. To improve the quality of lime mortar and to achieve early strength, the cement is sometimes added to it. This process is known as a gauging. It makes lime mortar economical, strong, and dense enough. Usually, the portion of cement or lime is about 1:6 or 1:8. It is also known as the composite mortar or cement lime mortar. This mortar may be used for the bedding and for thick brick wall. And the last is the gypsum mortar. This gypsum mortar is prepared by the gypsum from the gypsum by the binding material such as building gypsum and anhydrite building materials. This gypsum is used for coating or making of like false ceiling, etc. The next one is the nature of application. According to the nature of application, the mortars are classified, broadly classified into two categories. The first one is the bricklaying mortar. The mortar which is used in the brickwork is known as the bricklaying mortar. Upon the working condition and type of construction, the composition of masonry mortar with respect to kind of building material is decided. Next one is the finishing mortar. This type of mortar is used for the finishing work only, just to make the architectural view or ornamental effects. The cement or lime is generally used as a binding material for ordinary plastering mortar. In the fourth, decorative finishing, the mortar is composed of suitable materials, due consideration of mobility, water retention, resistance to atmospheric action, like some environmental effects that may be acid rain, normal rain. Next is the special mortars. These special mortars are developed on the specific requirement. These are as follows. Like first one is the fire resistant mortar. Second one is the lightweight mortar. Third one, packing mortar. Fourth one, sound absorbing mortar. And fifth is the X-ray shielding mortar. So as far as the their application is concerned, it is mentioned, it is clearly mentioned or reflecting with the name like fire resistant mortar. So fire resistant mortar is normally used in the oven, furnace, or in some those places where fire can be placed. This mortar is prepared by adding aluminum cement to the finely crushed powder of fire bricks. The fire bricks are those bricks which are overburnt in the kiln. The usual proportion is one part of aluminum cement and two parts of the finely powdered fire bricks. By the mixing of these material, the fire resistant mortar can be prepared. The next is the lightweight mortar. This mortar is prepared by adding such materials like sawdust, wood powder, etc. to lime mortars or cement mortar. This, beside these materials, there are some more materials which can be also used to make the lightweight mortars. These are asbestos, fibers, jute fibers, coir, and some other materials are there in that. So this can be used for the soundproofing or heat proofing construction. Next is the packing mortar. This mortar is used to prepare or used in the such kind of construction or structures where the specially like hydrogeological conditions have to be improved, or we have to seal or lock the water. So we can use in the well construction, water retaining structure, to just to remove the voids of the rocks. So this packing mortar is used for the packing only. Next is the sound absorbing mortar. This sound absorbing mortar is used in the theaters, in cinema hall, just to reduce the noise in the hall. To reduce the noise level, the sound absorbing plaster is formed by using some lightweight material like cement, lime, gypsum, and some lightweight aggregates like pumice and cinder. The bulk density of the such mortar varies from 6 to 12 kN per cubic meter and used in the classrooms, lecture theaters, etc. The next and last is X-ray shielding mortar. This type of mortar is used to providing the plaster coat to wall where the X-ray cabinets or X-ray procedures can be done. It is a heavy type of mortar with bulk density over 22 kilogram per Newton per cubic meter. The aggregates are obtained are heavy and that are derived from the rocks. Suitable admixtures can be added to that to improve or enhance the property of these protective mortars. Now, there are some properties of good mortars. It should be capable of developing good adhesion with the building units such as bricks, stone, etc. It should be capable of developing a design stress. It should be capable of resisting penetration of rainwater. It should be cheap, durable, and should be used quickly in the construction as well. So this is all about the lime mortar. So we'll meet again in our next lecture, which is timber and protective covering. Till then, take care, and thanks to all of you for listening my lecture. We'll meet in next lecture with new topic that I have mentioned in my previous slide. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.